Hi guys, I'm Marcus Imes. Thanks for tuning in again. I want to show you around one of our most popular new products, the Desktop Mill. It's our most compact and economical way to learn the Haas control and three-axis CNC programming. We designed the Desktop Mill to be the next step up from the Haas control simulator as a training tool. Although the control looks like a simulator, it's actually the exact same full-featured control you'd find on any of our other machines, like the VF2 over here. I want to show you how easy it is to set up the Desktop Mill and use VPS conversational programming to generate some code. So you can see here, I have a couple blocks of plastic on the table to work with. We mostly recommend cutting plastic or machinable wax on this machine since the material is cheap and reduces damage if a crash occurs. Or, for the ultimate in simplicity, we offer the spring-loaded pen attachment, which mounts directly in the spindle. Then, you can put a clipboard and a piece of paper on the table and use the Desktop Mill to draw shapes with CNC code. But today, we're gonna make some chips. So, I have my 1/8-inch three-flute end mill, and I'll tighten this in the spindle. I should mention, the spindle has a permanent female ER11 collet interface for the spindle nose, so you'll need a set of ER11 collets for each machine. Now, I'll tighten my tool in the spindle. It's a small tool, so don't over-tighten it. Next, we need to give the machine some Z geometry. So, we'll set our Z axis offset to the top of the stock to establish my Z height. I have a piece of paper here we'll use as a shim to pinch between the tool and the workpiece. Now that I've made contact between the tool and my workpiece, I'll use this as my work offset for my tool. Now, I'm going to set my work offset. I'm going to hand jog the spindle to where I want to set X0, Y0. And then set my G54 work offset. So let's do that. Move up Z a little bit. And I'm just gonna eyeball this, but if you wanted to be more accurate, you could use an edge finder as well. So I'm gonna set my X0, Y0 where I'm at right now. I'll go over to my offset page. From the offset, I'll hit F4. And in this case, looks like we already have some numbers in G54, G55, so I'm gonna use work offset G56. I'll push part 0 set for X and again for Y. And I'm gonna leave Z blank, although on most of our machines you would set a Z work offset. Here, all of my Z geometry comes from my tool since there's no tool changer on this machine. Now that I have my X, Y, and Z established, let's go to VPS and make a short program. You can find VPS under the Edit button, then tab up to the top and over to VPS, and then go down to the VPS, and we'll go over. As you can see here, you have a few different shapes we can easily make, like bosses, pockets, drill patterns, but today I think we'll do a little engraving. So let's see what it takes to operate one of the VPS templates. These are all composed in a very similar manner, and basically you're just answering questions from top to bottom. We have useful pictures that help determine what inputs we're looking for, and we have some help text down here. So the first thing it's asking for is our work offset. By default it chooses G54, but if you remember, I set G56. So I'm going to enter 56 and enter button, and now we're using offset G56. Next, it's asking for our tool number. I can tell we are currently using tool 2 from the offset table, or from the memory screen, it also tells me tool 2 is currently active. I'm going to leave that alone since we don't have a tool changer, so 2 is a good number. Now it's asking for my spindle speed. How fast do we want the cutter to turn? I have a valid range of 50 to 24,000, so quite a bit of range in there. I'm gonna choose 5,000 RPM, just from my experience, and I know that that won't be too fast for this machine. Since we don't have coolant, I don't want to melt the plastic, so I'm going to select 5,000 and press enter. Next, I need to give it a feed rate. How fast do we want to move? Well, how do we calculate that? Since I selected 5,000 RPM, and I know my end mill has 3 flutes, and I know a good chip load for this plastic material is 2,000ths per flute, I take 15,000 times 0.002, which would give me 30 inch per minute. So I'm going to enter 30 with a decimal because this one requires a decimal. Next, M8 is asking coolant or no coolant. This is a code all new machinists will learn very early on. And this is one way that VPS reinforces codes where applicable. So if you're choosing a canned cycle or like coolant on, coolant off, we're gonna reinforce that with the actual M or G code in the template. In this case, we don't have coolant, so I'm gonna enter 0. Now it's saying, where do I wanna start? Since I positioned my G56X0 at the position that I wanna start engraving, I'm gonna leave this one as 0. But I am gonna move Y up about 100 thousandths to get us off the center line of the part. So I'm gonna enter 0.1. Now here is my rapid plane. The rapid plane is where the tool changes from G0 rapid approach to a G1 feed move. The default we have in there is 100 thousandths of an inch. I'm gonna leave that alone because that's a pretty industry standard number. Now it's asking for my Z depth. How deep do I wanna cut? I know that this plastic top, the red plastic on the top of this part, is 50 thousandths deep. So I'm gonna say give it a value of maybe 70 thousandths, so we cut down below into the white. Now we can do either text or serial number or a specific number if we wanted to do that. In this case, I'm gonna leave it 0 to select text. And we could, it's asking how high do I want it? A half inch looks good to me. And do I want it on an angle? In this case, no, I'm gonna go straight across, but you could also do it at any angle around the circle. And now at the bottom, what do we want to engrave? How about Haas CNC? And that's the last line of this template. So from here, we can do a couple things with it. If you notice up here, we have generate code with F4. So we can copy it to the clipboard if we wanted to paste this into a program. I can output it to MDI, or I can create a new program with it if I don't already have one established. In this case, I'm actually gonna use the fourth option, which is just pushing cycle start, and that will run the template directly from this page. But before I do that, I'm gonna move my machine away from the stock a little bit. In case I entered any bad numbers, I want some time to push stop. So let's do that. So first thing I'm gonna do is move Z away from the table a little bit, just in case I got anything wrong. This'll give me some time to realize that and stop it before I crash anything. So I'll go back to my VPS template. I'm gonna change my rapid down to 5%, and I'll hit cycle start. Once I'm confident it's moving in the right direction, I can change that rapid override to a higher value. Now since the desktop mill doesn't have a tool changer, the first thing it's gonna do is move to the back corner to a safe position and ask me if the right tool is loaded in the spindle. This way, you can make a program with multiple tools even without a tool changer. But since we already have the tool in the spindle, per the message on the screen, I'm gonna push the letter K to continue. And now I'm gonna change the rapid override down a little slower. Now that we're moving in the right direction, it looks like. Speed it up a little bit. And just to make sure I got all my heights correct, I'm gonna stop it just before it gets to the material and look at my distance to go screen. So I'm gonna press position and then tab over to distance to go. I see I have 49 thousandths, which looks about right. If that number was drastically different, that's your first warning that something is wrong and you should stop and double check everything you've done. Now that I've verified my distance to go is good, I'll press cycle start and continue. So I think you can see why there's a lot of excitement around the desktop mill. It takes a full-size machine's capabilities and shrinks it down to about the size of a mini fridge, but still allows hands-on setup, programming, and troubleshooting experience, which directly translate to our full-size machines. Check out HaasCNC.com to get a custom quote on your own desktop mill with our build and price tool today. Thanks for joining us.